I think everyone's going to leave the arena with a smile on their face.
Click, 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 click. There's a couple of scars here and there. Yeah.
Yeah.
Good point.
Yeah, hurling is fucking great. I adore it so much. Never will you, I don't think there, maybe from ice hockey, will you find a level of skill and violence equanimous to each other. Although, professional wrestling.
In fairness, like in hockey, they just like, just stop playing the game just to have a scrap, which I think is just like kind of missing the point a little bit. At least we're hurling, fighting is almost part of the game. It's not a little entertainment feature of it. It is literally, no, we're putting all these coaches on one field and giving them sticks and telling them, see that fella over there? He's British. That's essentially how to motivate a team of hurlers.
See that fella over there? He's not from this particular town.
Honestly, what kept us from having more civil wars? You can work your shit out during the game and everything's fine then.
That's how we got through the last few decades of rage.
Leave it on the pitch. Go for your scoops. Sunday league, at its best.
There was that clip going around one time, like someone getting an absolute fucking like clock across the face and getting knocked out in a GA final. Like your man picks him up, he takes a bucket and they shake hands after. It's just like, we're not a civilized people.
No, if you've ever stood on Hill 16, that's it. You kind of get to know who you are as a person by you either being fully invigorated or horrified by that experience. I was told to calm down. I was told to calm down as an 11-year-old. I was being too abusive to a referee.
You have to respect the referees.
Don't be fuck. It was from Mead.
You didn't mention that.
You skipped that part of the detail there, Brian.
What a fucking real. I was so entrenched in sport. I adored sport fully. And now I've stepped away from it. It's mental. Sport's fucking crazy.
Yeah.
We're all going to wear the same t-shirt and hate each other for a specific amount of time and then go back into society like everything didn't just happen.
It is pretty much just Fight Club, just endorsed to a certain degree.
Fight Club, voyeurism edition.
Yeah.
Also known as Fight Club the movie. God damn, it's a sexy film.
My favourite thing about that film is people keep missing the goddamn point.
Yep. No.
Soap is dangerous.
It's a fantastic movie. But yeah, people don't. It's a satire.
It's like it's the same as American Psycho. I was reading something about that today, like where like, you know, Patrick Bateman is a kind of a symbol of like a male power fantasy symbol. It's like, no, he's a piss take. Like, yep. Patrick Bateman is one of the saddest cunts to have ever existed. Like the guy gets
you're
up
not
before
to empathize with him.
Yeah.
What is like wrong with you?
He is to be pitied. Like, he is a sad human being. Like, this is the whole point. He is literally the first ever LinkedIn wanker. That's not someone to be celebrating. Like, that's, if anything, if you're aligning with him, you're actually showing how sad you are. But trust me. You know?
When it's all said and done and my dad learned some humility, it will all have been worth it. Yeah.
Yeah.
I watch Fight Club like once every year and it's a different film every time.
Mm.
Right now I'm loving the furniture. Lovely furniture. Really lets you know where you're at in your life. Watch Fight Club. Either stand on Hill 16 or watch Fight Club and you'll know exactly who you are as a person. Reason I have no intention of going anywhere near Hill 16. I know what you said. Fuck that. I know what I've become. You can keep like the only reason anybody ever gets away with being an absolute mad bastard is abs and cheekbones, of which ample in Fight Club and American Psycho.
This is fair.
get away with a lot if you're gorgeous. I know a bit about that myself. I get away with nothing.
Oh, God.
Called out on all my bullshit. Every fucking
great right away. Yeah.
All the time. I just heard that your GM banned you from the arena this week. He did, yeah. Too bad for him that he can't throw out a paying customer. I left you a
ringside seat ticket at the box office. I'm sure you'll put it. But he has a blacklist for a reason.
It's called an African American list.
Whoops, sir.
Actually, totally isn't anymore. We've now turned another corner, and that's no longer the way to do it.
We've moved on as a society.
We've learned. We've grown. We're living. We're laughing. We're loving.
Yep.
I think,
for example, I have it on good authority from working various Pride events that what used to be a slur in my youth is now actually the preferred term. Queer.
Yes.
Oh.
They have to take them. They say they've taken back that word now, which is great.
Yeah.
I really, really thought you were going to say. The thing that was a slur as a kid is preferred. They like being called.
No, still a slur.
That's next.
We'll get there.
It's a learning.
I quite like queer. I always when I first knew of the arrangement of letters, I always thought, I like that Q one. I like that one myself. Seems to really make a lot of sense. As is evident.
Hmm.
Yeah. I'm on that rainbow. Holy fuck. It's like, oh no, this is just completely logic, rationale that I'm having. No. No, don't you worry. You're a part of the team. Not everyone's as happy about it as you are, John. Should have told myself that. Same age that I was being told I was less manly because of fucking shin guards. Maybe I would not have cried that day.
Brian, what you need to do now is if you're at a Pride event this month, just go around asking people, listen, this is going to sound like a strange question, but did you happen to wear shin guards when you were playing hurling? I was like, as a matter of fact, yes, I did.
And the response would always be, yes, queen, play.
Play, tuck, follow.
Oh... Big long puck.
How isn't that on a name of an Irish drag queen? Puck Fada. Like, that's a perfect name, isn't it? Like,
amazing. PH. PHUC.
Yeah. Oh my god, he's smashing that rendered image of Vince McMahon. Somebody stop him.
Tommy Dreamer wrestling for Vinnie Mac.
Oh my god. Oh, he's just kicked down the podium. Oh my god. Have you no shame, William Regal, on this of all holy occasions? Another Vince McMahon circle jerk. How could you ruin this moment for him?
Surprisingly enough, for all of the latent homoeroticism, Vince McMahon, not on the flag.
That we're aware of.
He's probably so in the closet.
My God. Big gay Vince. Yeah, and these two extremists are gonna
make him pay. Real smart move. You're aware the World Bodybuilding Federation was a thing, right?
Yeah, Gary Stridham. Have you ever heard him seeing Gary Stridham? Oh my God.
I really, really want Vince to be gay now.
You cannot tell me that he did not have feelings about that Shawn Michaels Playgirl shoot.
Who do you think was taking the pictures?
Yeah.
Who do you think rubbed the baby oil on?
Now, Sean, just for me, take the title off.
Slowly.
You
know what? Vince isn't gay enough to be gay.
There's the stereotypical gay, but then there's the ones who are like Vince.
It's like they're like
you like little feminine women, do you? Have you seen what I do for fun?
Yeah. I too enjoy watching Steve Hughes. Straight, it's the new gay. What do you like? A woman, soft, feminine.
What do you like, Dave? Oh, fuck a bloke. I know a big, strong, hairy bloke fuck me in the ass.
Let me tell you it.
Yeah. He's just a nasty man. I love the fact that, like, it's such a nice place to have in my head that you can think, I don't want Vince to be gay. He's not nice enough as a human. Hmm. And there's a lovely divide there that it's like, oh, anything queer related isn't inherently evil. It's a nice thing to have in my head, contrary to my upbringing. the general surrounding area and culture. So it's wonderful to think. But I don't think anyone was prepared for this. And yet, I gotta admit,
it took me by surprise. And yet, that
doesn't happen. A president of America? That's an understatement. You've been in hundreds of matches in your career. It ain't happening for lovely fucking time. What do you think happened first?
We've already had a gay president, so.
I know, so. I know, we're great. Ireland's fantastic. He is a scumbag. But it's not about who you do, it's about what you do.
Oh, no, I was referring to a gay American president. We already have one of them. Like, you can't convince me that Donald Trump is a straight man. Look at these hands. These are not the hands of a straight man. Okay, this is not what straight men do. Okay,
this is
the drag queen doing their fucking best. Okay,
drag queens of like artistry and style.
If Donald Trump's dad was actually more open-minded when he was a baby, when he was a child,
Donald
he
Trump
could have been the most sashaying gay man that's ever lived. You're wrong. You're incorrect. You're an asshole. I don't like you. You're all bitches. I'm gonna get the fuck out of here now.
I think Donald Trump to a drag queen is like Mewtwo and Mew in Pokemon and Ditto. Donald Trump is a Ditto drag queen.
Let's see that.
That's a deep cut for anyone who knows their Pokemon lore, by the way.
He is a failed fucking blob. That's what he is. And yet he's hilarious.
He does feel like a vague approximation of a human.
Really is.
Done badly.
Yeah.
If you like ask your 5-year-old to draw your granddad, you'd probably get Donald Trump, wouldn't you? Like small head, big hair, huge fucking stomach.
Really, really problematic opinions. Kids, man, they go hard. They don't give a fuck. you give them that bottle. Oh, Charlie, they're coming at you. They're gonna hit you personally. I've said it before, and I'll say it again. Nothing costs you. They have no scruples. None. They're wild. They're unprocessed human. They're not cooked yet. That's Donald Trump. He got took out of the oven too soon. He is a soft in the middle biscuit of man. No superstar in the locker room can the only billionaire to turn himself into a millionaire.
you can't say he's affected by downsizing, that's for sure.
No. Well, he's
bank balance getting smaller and he gets getting fatter. Maybe that's why he keeps losing money. He's actually eating it.
He's like a dragon.
Yeah.
Oh, he's a dragon queen. That's what it is.
Yeah, there you have it. We were close. We were
right there.
The only president to serve McDonald's in the White House.
I don't know. I get the feeling that JFK had a sneaky Big Mac every now and then. Like, did we know that for sure? Was he not on the phone going, are you fancy some chicken nuggets?
I checked his cheeky Big Macs for a hat in the brothels that he frequented.
I was just going to say, cheeky Big Mac, don't you talk about Marilyn Monroe like that? Have fun editing this, Jonathan.
Huh? I might have to get Kira to do the legal on it. We'll get there.
There's some fucking good ones.
Yeah. Must get a disclaimer up somewhere in the background here and be like, lads, I'm actually just joking.
We might be reshooting the entirety of December.
Brian has been replaced by just a cardboard cutout of someone who isn't fucking broken inside.
Brian's on event. Brian's been cancelled. Send me his non-unionized, non-problematic equivalent.
Be cool.
Suddenly Dave is just replaced. But I like the idea that we, you know, go as far as Survivor Series and it's the show as usual, and then for some reason from Survivor Series to the Rumble, it's just the game. There's no commentary, there's no faces.
Just freeze framed all of a sudden for some reason, for just weird reason, like.
Yeah, yeah. Just a little hashtag pops up in the corner every now and again. Hashtag blame Brian. Like, we just had too much fun. That was the problem.
We did have it. We did. Cool.
You know what it is? Top geared ourselves. That's what it was.
That's it. We punched the producer. We sparked the producer out. That's what happened there.
That's it. That's exactly it.
Well, that's what you get for being Irish. Yeah, but
they gave fucking great voiceovers. Like, I knew nothing about cars, and then I watched Top Gear, and then for a half an hour, I knew stuff about cars. There's a vehicle in my garden right now. I think it's called a car.
Four wheels, headlights, steering wheel, seats.
Technically six wheels. One of them's in the boot.
Either a car or three cycles combined together, but carry on.
Casey holds them together. He's very strong. Very strong and beautiful man.
He's a good lad. He's a good lad, Casey. He gets around a lot.
Everyone give him money.
Throwback. Yeah. I like that.
Hey.
Dude, like several weeks ago.
if anyone actually caught that canonically and is watching it, I was like, you are great. I love you. I've had the car for about a year, and I know because I have to pay the government to keep it on the road. And I haven't put air in the tires of that vehicle. Technically.
You should do that.
Technically.
I literally had to do that yesterday while driving back and forth.
A flat tire is considered to be under 20 PSI. My right tire was
very low.
My right tire was 18. Jeez. That's the bit I sit on. Mm-hmm. That's my side.
None of my... to 27 and the car screamed at.
I've driven this car to Wexford. Like down and back, return journey. Very recently, on that tire pressure. I don't know how I'm not still currently in a ditch.
Yeah, that's a health risk.
Yeah.
At best.
Jesus.
My point being, I know fuck all about cars. But there has to come a point when what you don't know about something isn't really an excuse. Have since learned. I feel grown up and I feel capable. And does anyone want to lift?
I will. I do you know what, Brian? I'll take your offer and I'll bring my own compressor.
Beautiful.
Like, I thought there was something wrong with the suspension.
You were in the right ballpark, but you were kind of like looking anywhere. Like, if you just kind of followed the suspension to its natural conclusion, you would have got there.
Corners feel smoother. Speed bumps. Slightly bumpier, actually, now. Slightly bumpier. Kind of, you know.
No, that's okay. That's what you're expecting, is the, like, with the higher pressure is less contact with the road. So that's fine. Yeah. It's okay.
What I do miss, though, it's, like, I believe it or not, big fan of, like, heavy metal, rock music, and rah-rah stuff.
It's not really sounding as good in the car anymore. There's a lack of, like, accompanying metal scraping that isn't happening. I kind of miss it. You know, like when, like, smoke alarm's going off, or like the neighbor's house alarm's going off, or such and such long period of long noise drowning out all the time, and then it stops and you kind of miss it.
That's where you're at with your car.
Yeah. I miss the sparks was the great bit. Really brought vivaciousness to the journey. Made me look like I was going faster. I felt like Doc Brown.
Here's a man who enjoys inflicting pain upon his opponents. Well, 80 miles an hour was probably a bad decision on under pressure tires as well, though.
I was going for ECW lately. I think we're the speed limit. A new champion. On a national motorway. When I had to overtake somebody. Which then by right means you go over the speed limit to safely overtake somebody.
He's made an enemy of Mr. McMahon. He's been targeted by ECW, and his championship is on the line here tonight.
So, here's Armageddon. Our most feud has been about ECW and teaching ECW a lesson and going to ECW pay-per-view and smashing up all their main stars. Mm-hmm. And now we have to defend our title, our mandatory defense for the month, and the promo package all very much pointed to us wrestling Kane, but because we beat him on the first week of SmackDown, therefore denying him a chance to the world title, we now face Chavo Guerrero instead, who apparently was too shit to make the promo package, so we just reused the one from Kane instead, as if he was meant to win the whole time. This game needs to sort out what it means by booking a card and not just random fucking matches.
This game is sort of shit.
The problem is Tony Khan played this game too much in his youth. Thought he was learning, and now we have it in real life.
In fairness, I can kind of see that. Like, this seems like his kind of game.
It matches up a little too well, doesn't it?
There hasn't been a single tournament you start talking bollocks. Where are the tournaments? Show me the tournaments. But also, yeah, what the fuck? Agree, 100%.
Exactly.